Hello, I'm Dr. Danny Gnewikow. I am the founder and chief audiologist for Audiology Hearing Aid Associates in Danville and Lynchburg, Virginia. This video is one of a multi-part series that we have designed to answer some of the most frequently asked questions about hearing aids and hearing loss. Today's question, do hearing aids still squeal in your ear like I heard in church one time? Well, unfortunately, they can if the hearing aid is improperly fit or improperly programmed. But once it's done right, it's not a problem. Basically, feedback or squealing occurs when the microphone of the hearing aid picks up and attempts to reprocess the amplified signal from the receiver or speaker of the hearing aid. Now, the stronger the amplified signal is, the more difficult it becomes to keep the sound from leaking out of the ear canal. And this leakage of sound is what causes the acoustic feedback. And so, of course, you would expect that a person that has a more severe hearing loss, where the hearing aid is much more powerful, would be more likely to cause feedback than a hearing aid that maybe did not require as much power. Now, the four major causes of feedback are, number one, an improper physical fit of the hearing aid in the ear canal. That could be due to a bad impression, that could be due to a problem at the manufacturer, but basically, if the hearing aid is not sealing the ear properly, feedback is more of a problem. The second possibility would be the improper insertion of the hearing aid into the ear canal. Sometimes people don't have good dexterity, or maybe their memory is not as good as it used to be, and they're having a little difficulty getting it in the ear. The third possibility is that the hearing aid has not been properly programmed in the higher frequencies. And then the last cause can be the hearing aid may not be equipped with automatic feedback reduction. Now, if those are the problems, what are the solutions? Well, they're fairly simple. The first solution is make sure the hearing aid fits well. If necessary, remake the hearing aid. If necessary, make a new impression of the ear. The second method used to eliminate the squeal or the feedback would be spend a little extra time with that patient. Teach them how to properly insert the hearing aid. Maybe work with their family a little bit. Let the family kind of become their teacher at home, and hopefully they'll learn to do it more easily. The third method of dealing with this is better programming. Again, a hearing aid that is inaccurately programmed may cause feedback, and it also may not be giving patients the degree of word understanding that they would really like. And the fourth, and probably one of the best approaches, is the use of automatic feedback reduction in the new digital hearing aids. What this does is allows the hearing aid to sense the feedback, and then accordingly it will make a correction. A well-fit and accurately programmed hearing aid will not have feedback. Remember, today's technology is not your father's hearing aid. I hope this information has been helpful. Thanks for listening.